Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Hello everyone, this is Imran Pardesi sir. And today we will be continuing our standard 9th math second chapter number 2, parallel lines. Dear students, in 8th standard we had learned about parallel lines and its transversal and the properties of parallel lines and its transversal. So I will repeat the previous knowledge. Please pay attention because this chapter is totally based on the angles and the properties of parallel lines. Please pay attention, you had learned, you know this. Okay, so students, we will start from what is parallel line. When the two lines are lying in the same plane, okay, see, this is going in the same plane, this is going in the same plane, same direction, this is going in the same direction. So when two lines, if they are lying in the same plane, are and they do not intersect each other, and they do not intersect each other, are said to be parallel lines. And can you see here line L and line M? Two lines are parallel to each other, they are lying in a same plane. Yes, and can you see this? This is a line N. This is a transversal because this line N is a transversal because it intersecting line L and line M at two distinct points. Line N, line L और M को दो जगह पर, दो पॉइंट पर इंटरसेक्ट करती है, so therefore this is a transversal and total A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, it means total 8 angles will form, is it clear, total 8 angles बनेंगे, so students we will see one by one over here, you had learned in your previous classes, see now, corresponding angles, so what is corresponding angle will be here, so students can you see here, D, angle D will be corresponding to angle H. Is it clear? So now you tell me angle A. Angle A will be corresponding to which angle? Angle E. Is it clear? Angle E. Now angle C. Angle C will be corresponding to angle G. Now angle B will be corresponding to angle F. I hope you understood. This is corresponding angles and they are congruent. This is the symbol of congruent. Congruent means equal. It means angle D will be equals to angle H because they are corresponding angle. Angle A will be equal to angle E because they are corresponding angles. Okay, now see, angle C will be equal to angle G. Angle B will be equal to angle F. It means they are corresponding angle, therefore the angles will be congruent to each other. What is congruent? Equal, same. Now see here, alternate interior angles. Alternate chahiye but interior. Is it clear? So you will focus on the interior angles, that is B, C, E, H. Okay, these four angles are interior. Four angles kahan par hai? Andar hai. That is why it is called interior. But you need to find alternate. Alternate matlab roll number 1 ke baad roll number 2 nahi, roll number 3, and roll number 2 ke baad roll number 3 nahi, roll number 4. Is it clear? So here also you can say alternate interior angles. So I will show here. See, angle B will be congruent to angle H. Is it clear? Now angle C will be congruent to angle E. Is it clear? So can you see B ke baad E nahi, H. So B or H alternate honge or interior honge kyunki wo andar hai. C ke baad B nahi, E hai because wo alternate hai, ek ke baad dusra. Is it clear? So now you will pay here, angle C is congruent to angle E and angle B is congruent to angle H and they are also congruent. Angle C jitne degree ka honga, angle E bhi utne hi degree ka hoga, and because they are alternate interior angles. Alternate interior angles ye sab kab banenge? Jab do lines parallel honge and one transversal will be there. It means, as we know, Z, hum use Z padhte hain, Z. Agar Z hua, agar Z banta hai, to wo alternate interior angle hote hai. Is it clear? Z aise bhi ban sakta hai. So this is and this is equal to each other, congruent. They are congruent to each other. Is it clear? Now focus here, alternate exterior angle. Abhi bahar ke angle. So students, you will pay attention towards the bahar ke angle. Now exterior angle. Then also alternate. So A is an exterior angle, A बाहर की तरफ है, तो A के बाद F बाहर है, फिर G है, फिर D है. तो A after alternate चाहिए, यानी उसके बाद वाला नहीं, उसके बाद वाला. एक के बाद दो नहीं तीन, दो के बाद तीन नहीं चार. Is it clear? So angle A will be congruent to angle G. Angle A जितना होगा, angle G भी उतना होगा, because it is alternate. Exterior angle, बाहर के angle है. So students now focus here also D, angle D, focus here D, angle D also exterior angle and angle F also exterior angle. Is it clear? So can you see angle D and angle F, angle D and angle F, exterior alternate exterior angle, बाहर के. Angle A and angle G, exterior, alternate exterior angle and they are congruent. Means वो भी आपस में same होंगे, congruent होंगे. Is it clear? So here interior angles on the same side. Now you have to focus on the interior angles only. How many interior angles? 4. How many exterior angles? 4. So you will pay attention on this interior angle. Angle C, angle B, angle E, angle H. Okay. But it is said interior angles on the same side of the transversal. Same side. It means, can you pay, please pay attention here. This angle B and angle E. So angle B plus angle E is equals to 180 degree. Angle B or angle E ko jab milayenge, so it will be 180 degree, means it is supplementary. See, and they are supplementary, it means 180 degree. So sum of the angle of the interior angles on the same side, ek hi taraf ke interior angles, right hand side mein kya hai, angle B or angle E, जब उसका सम होगा, एडिशन होगा, it should be 180 degree, that is supplementary. It means like here also, angle C and angle H. You will do the addition of angle C and angle H. See, angle C plus angle H is equals to 180 degree. It will be 180 degree, that is supplementary degree. Is it clear? Now, can you see here vertically opposite angles? Vertically opposite angles. So students pay attention here, what is vertically opposite angle? Angle A is vertically opposite to angle C. Is it clear? Now see, angle B is vertically opposite to angle D. I will use another pen. Please focus here. Okay, so vertically opposite angle, yani jaise yahan par alternate angle mein Z banta hai, vertically opposite angle mein aise do X banega. So a vertically opposite angles will be congruent to each other like this. Please pay attention here. So this is and this is vertically opposite angle. It means this is and this is also vertically opposite angle. Ye aur ye, usi tarah se ye aur ye vertically opposite honge. Is it clear? I hope you understood what is vertically opposite angle. So here below, angle E is vertically opposite to angle G. Angle E is vertically opposite to angle G. Now see, angle H is vertically opposite to angle F. Is it clear? I have written over here, B is opposite to D, A is opposite to C, E is opposite to G, F is opposite to H. Is it clear? And they are congruent. Congruent symbol equal. They are congruent. Yani H jitna honga, F utna hi major ka hoga. Angle, major angle E jitna hoga, major angle G bhi utna hi hoga. So students, last but not the least, please pay attention. Angles in a linear pair. So what is angles in a linear pair? Please pay attention. Like this. Ek hi line par, aise do, yahan pe X hai, yahan pe Y. It means ek hi line pe, ye A aur ye B hai, is it clear, aur ye O hai. So ek hi line par do angle bane hai, C O B and C O A. Ek angle idhar hai, ek angle idhar hai. Is it clear? So this is called angles in a linear pair, baazu baazu mein. So look at here, I will say angle A, see angle A plus angle B, ye dono aapas mein baazu mein hai, beech mein ek common arm hai. Can you see here? OC is common here also and there also. Please pay attention here. OC kya hai? Ek arm hai. Angle ka ek arm hai. Jo yahan par bhi hai aur wahan par bhi hai. It means it is a common arm. Is it clear? So what I will say here, angle A plus angle B, ye do angle, angle A plus angle B will be 180 degree. Why? Because they are angles in a linear pair. Can you see, ek hi line par do angle bante hai, ek us taraf, ek is taraf, jiska ek arm congruent hai, common hai, common hai. Now see, can I say angle A and angle D also is a angles in a linear pair? Dekho baazu, aapas mein baazu baazu dikhte hai, beech mein ek arm hai, angle A, angle D. In dono ki addition 180 hogi because angles in the linear pair is 180 degree. Now here, angle C, angle D also angles in the linear pair. Kya matlab hota hai angles in the linear pair? Yani, ek hi line par, दो एंगल बनना, एक यहां पर, जिसमें एक आर्म कॉमन होगा, is it clear, and it will be supplementary, और वो कितना होगा, supplementary होगा, I hope you understood now here also, E plus angle H plus angle E is equals to 180 degree, because angles on a linear pair, I hope you understood. Can you see angle F plus angle G? ये दोनों भी एक arm common है, एक यहाँ पर भी है, angle F and angle G, E plus angle G plus angle F is equals to 180 degree. Yes. Why? Because it is angles in a linear pair. I hope you understood this, my explanation. This everything we had learned in 8th standard. There was a second chapter, parallel lines and its transversal. I hope you understood. After explanation of parallel lines and its property, we will see theorem now. Students, this theorem is new for you in this class. And in question number 3b, one theorem will be asked in your exam. Theorem, ek theorem aapke exam mein aayegi, first semester mein bhi aur second semester mein bhi. So what is theorem? Ye theorem ke aage jo likha hua hai, the corresponding angles formed by a transversal of two parallel lines are of equal measures. यही आपका क्वेश्चन होगा क्वेश्चन नंबर 3b में. Is it clear? यही आपका क्वेश्चन होगा. You have to write from given till end. Given भी लिखना है, डायग्राम भी ड्रॉ करनी है, इसी सब लिखना है. Is it clear? पेपर में सिर्फ ये स्टेटमेंट होगी, the corresponding angles formed by a transversal of two parallel lines are of equal measures. So it means we have to show corresponding angles are congruent to each other. ये हमने अभी एक्सप्लेनेशन में पढ़ा. So look at here on this figure, line L is parallel to line M. Can you see? Yes. Angle A is correspondent to angle B. We have to prove, हमको प्रूफ करना है. Line L parallel to line M and line N is a transversal. दिख रहा है, line N is a transversal. Yes. Line L is parallel to line M. Yes. Now we have to prove. To prove, angle A is equals to angle B. Angle A जितना है, angle B भी उतना ही होगा. ये हमको प्रूफ करना है. Means it is a corresponding. Angle A और angle B corresponding angles है. Proof. What proof you will give? Can you see here? I have tick mark. Angle A और angle C. Angle A और angle C एक दूसरे के बाजू में है और बीच में एक arm है, एक हाथ है जो common है. It means it is angles in a linear pair. Can I write angle A plus angle C, आजू बाजू में है, angle A plus angle C is equals to 180 degree. This is my first answer. Why? Because angles in a linear pair are of 180 degree. Is it clear? Now I will write angle C. See a red mark, angle C plus angle B. ये interior angles है, वो भी on the same side, एक ही side के interior angles है, अंदर के angles है, angle B और angle C एक तरफ के interior angles है, तो कितने degree के होंगे वो? 180 degree. See, angle C plus angle B is equals to 180 degree. ये मेरा second answer होगा. I have written over here interior angles on the same side. Okay, statements आपको लिखना compulsory है. Okay, so now can I say angle A plus angle C is equals to angle C plus angle B? Yes, because इसकी value भी 180 है और इसकी value भी 180 है. It means ये दोनों equal है, ये और ये equal है. So I have written over here. But we had learned that equal sign के left और right. ओके, इक्वल साइन के लेफ्ट और राइट अगर कोई टर्म सेम होगा तो कैंसिल हो जाएगा. सो हियर कैन यू सी एंगल सी और एंगल सी इज अ लाइक टर्म, सो दे विल गेट कैंसिल. सो व्हाट विल रिमेन? एंगल ए इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल बी. कैन इट इज प्रूव दिस स्टेटमेंट इज पॉसिबल? बिकॉज़ फ्रॉम फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड आंसर ये और ये इक्वल है फ्रॉम फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड आंसर इज इट क्लियर एट लास्ट देयरफॉर एंगल ए इज इक्वल्स टू एंगल बी आई होप यू अंडरस्टूड ये जो स्टेटमेंट है यही आपके क्वेश्चन पेपर में होगा आपको गिवन से यहां तक डायग्राम के साथ ये स्टेटमेंट के साथ एज इट इज लिखना है इज इट क्लियर नाउ स्टूडेंट्स प्लीज लुक एट हियर ऑन प्रैक्टिस सेट 2.1 क्वेश्चन नंबर 1 लाइन आरपी आरपी इज अ लाइन parallel this is symbol of parallel line ms ms is also parallel to rp and line dk dk is a transversal okay so what is given angle dhp dhp is 85 so I will write over here this is 85 degree okay this is dhp okay 85 degree find the measures of the following so 1 2 3 4 we have to find the measures of these four angles Is it possible to find? Yes, why not? First is RHD. Where is RHD? RHD. 85 ke baazu wala. 85 ke baazu wala. So what it is? Can you see? Aazu baazu mein hai aur ek arm jo common hoga. So here, can I use interior angles on the same? Can I use it angles in a linear pair? Yes, angles in a linear pair. Ek hi aazu baazu mein hai aur beech mein ek arm hai. So I will use in, angles in a linear pair so I will use angle RHD jo find karna hai plus angle DHP jo diya hua hai is equals to 180 degree why I will write this is my first why I will write this angles in a linear pair you have to write here angles in a linear pair angles in a linear pair okay so now how much RHD therefore RHD plus DHP is of how much degree 85 degree and 180 degree so this will go there so therefore RHD is equals to 180 degree minus 85 this 85 will go there it will be minus So 180 minus 85, your answer will be how much? 95 degree. Is it clear? I hope you understood. Therefore, angle RHD is equals to 95 degree. I hope you understood. Okay. So now this is how much? 95 degree. Okay. What is next? PHG. P HG, PHG, yani ye angle, okay? So once you know this, can I use vertically opposite angle here? Yes or no? Can I use vertically opposite here? This is 95, this also will be 95. This is 85, this will also 85. Yes or no? Vertically opposite angles. Yes or no, 85, this also will be 85. So like this is exterior angle, this is also exterior angle, 85. This is exterior angle, this is also 95. Is it clear? If this is 85 degree, can I say it is corresponding? See, this is also 85. Do you understand what I am saying here? Yes or no? Once you got two angle, agar aapko do measurement mil jate hai, The whole answers you know. Is it clear? So now I will use one by one. Angle PHG. Angle PHG. 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 So can I say angle PHG is equals to angle RHD. PHG is equals to RHD. Why? Vertically opposite. Vertically opposite angles are congruent same hote hai therefore I will write angle PHG is equals to RHD ki value kitni hai 95 degree is it clear so answer you got second answer you got PHG is how much 95 degree 85 85 95 95 85 85 you should know ki do answer mil gaye then you should know the property of two parallel lines and transversal vertically same corresponding same exterior alternate same is it clear now I have to find third one that is HGS, where it is HGS, yani ye wala. So it will be a corresponding angle. Yes, I will write over here angle. What is given in the question? DHP. See here, DHP, ye wala. DHP is 85. So can I write P? What is to be find? Third one, HGS. HGS is corresponding angle. Can you see? Is equals to angle HGS. Why? Because they are corresponding angles are congruent, same होंगे. तो DHP जितना होगा, HGS भी उतना ही होगा. So DHP कितना है? कितने डिग्री का है? How much it is? 85 degree. So angle HGS is equals to 85 degree. You will write it correctly. Angle HGS is equals to 85 degree. Is it clear? Is it clear? Corresponding angle होंगे DHP और HGS corresponding angle होंगे. Is it clear? Now fourth one, MGK. MG, where is K? Down. MGK यानी exterior. Can I say DHP 85 तो MGK भी 85? Because this is exterior, so this is also exterior. देखो DHP exterior है और तो MGK is also exterior, alternate है. Can you see alternate? Yes, so I will write it over there. Angle MGK is equals to angle DHP. Why I will write this? What statement I should write? Exterior alternate angles are congruent. So therefore angle MGK will be DHP of how much degree? 85. Did you get it? Did you understand what I said? I hope you understood here. DHP 85. So this is DH, RHD is a angles in a linear pair. So you can find out by subtracting from 180. DHP, see here, DHG, DH, PHG, PHG is of 95. Why? Because it is vertically opposite angle of RHD. Is it clear? DHP is 85. So HGS, it will be a corresponding angle. I hope you understood this. And the question number 2 is exactly like this. You will solve it as a homework. I hope you understood it. Best of luck. Thank you.